I'm doing a history project on Industrial Revolution. Instead of doing it with incremental reading, which can just generate a lot of facts that nobody's interested in, I will do it with YouTube. While watching videos, while learning, I'll be creating my presentation at the same time, so that I'll kill two birds with one stone, having lots of fun. I've been already working with this collection for like 2 months. I just do a little bit every day, just like not to get bored or tired. The first thing I did was to search for Industrial Revolution as the keyword. So I'll try to simulate how this would look like. So I'll press Control F3, write Industrial Revolution. Click OK, choose YouTube for search. I'll immediately see a couple of interesting programs, so I'll just middle click to open a new tab, middle click, avoid anything that is sponsored, middle click, and have lots of videos like that. Now I want to import all that to SuperMemo, so I'll choose Shift F8, which is the same as Edit Web Import. Shift F8. There was a little bug in SuperMemo that when you open all those YouTubes for import, they start playing, so there's a little bit of cacophony. I see I have already lots of those videos imported, so I'll just filter them out. And I see, yeah, I got like a couple of new videos. So I'll click the first, click the last to choose them all. I'll close them on import. Actually, I could have used import from YouTube this way. I'll filter out any other. Oh, actually, I see, yeah. This one is not YouTube. I'm importing from Edge, but importing from Chrome would work equally well, so import. And I have those videos nicely imported to SuperMemo. If you look at the history of my imports, the best videos, you can see I had Industrial Revolution later, trains, steam engines, Nikola Tesla. It's actually part of Second Industrial Revolution, but that was interesting. The steamships, Jay Leno and his steam car, this kind of stuff. So everything really truly interesting. Now I have imported a little batch of Industrial Revolution videos, and I would like to introduce them to the outstanding queue. This means that while learning today in this collection, every 2, 3, or 4 videos, depending on whatever parameter I choose, I'll have one of those new videos presented so that I could review there of any value, set the priority, set the interval, decide if I want to watch them today or tomorrow, or maybe later today, at what priority, how far I want to go, when they get boring, or perhaps some of them should be dismissed or sent beyond the project deadline so that I can watch them in the future, if ever. So for this sake, I'll go to the parent of that import node. That's Industrial Revolution, my current imports. I'll press Control Space to see the branch. And I'll spread those videos like, let's say, every third. So every third of the videos presented for review today will be one of those new videos. Every third, okay. Nice. Before I even go deeper, I want to have a look. I'm just curious what's inside of those videos. I'll start a little bit of learning already. So I will randomize those videos. And I'll simply just start learning.
How close were the Romans to an industrial revolution? After all, archaeology reveals they were already innovating on the use of advanced technologies like gears, ball bearings, and steam engines.
Now we can see it's something really interesting, so I'll give it a high priority, perhaps even one of my... Oh, it's already position 4, that's nice. But now I have reviewed this, so it's not due anymore. As you can see, it's not due. So I'll put it in position, say, 11, so... After 11 videos, I will just have a look at this one. Let's try another one of the new imports.
Hi, I'm John Green, and this is Crash Course European History. So we're going to turn our attention today to the...
For the presentation, we don't want people talking, but I don't want something more sexy, so I'll jump to some...
Culture, when you walk to town, you're either pulling your own cart, or if you're lucky, you have a horse. You have no running water or electric.
This might not be exactly what I need for my project, so maybe I'll set a lower priority if I have like 500 elements already. So I will set it somewhere at 66% of the queue. Let's keep going.
In the 1800s, most people worked in the fields on land they did not own. Those who owned the land, called aristocrats, lived refined lives in elegant manor houses.
That's interesting. For my presentation, I would like to have something in color. So maybe lower priority. I'll put it on position, say, 22. So it'd be 22nd most important video to review. And after I'm done with my review, I'll just press escape and say, I don't want to resume the subset. And I'll start my usual repetitions.
It turns out the newcomer.
This is the video. I'm quite advanced, if you can call 35 seconds advanced in comparison with the others. This is the video where I'm already watching.
Steam engine is not only the direct ancestor of modern engines, but its invention in 1712 helped set the stage for the machines that powered the Industrial Revolution.
That's exactly what I need for my project. So this video, I'll watch later, not to bore you now. And I have a couple of outstanding elements. So you could see how I import a new supplementary material. I'll show you my work notes. This is a better illustration of this whole process, how I diverge into different directions. So I was first learning about the Industrial Revolution, then I got interested in trains, then steam engines, steamships. I wanted to learn about photographs, never had time for this. Maybe later I wanted to learn about clothes industry, etc., etc. My best videos I'll present later. I also want to learn about personalities, Diesel, Trevithick, Savory. I already learned about what Newcomen and Stevenson. This presents more or less the evolution of thinking about what is interesting. I want to add more to my project. These are all future videos to be added to the project. So you've seen how I do the searches. When I do more supplementary material, it'll be exactly the same. It'll be Control F3, let's say Thomas Savory. Searching YouTube. Middle click on interesting videos. Maybe some of them will not even be about Savory. I might misclick and this guy might end up there. That's not a problem. It can always be deleted or dismissed. Actually, dismiss is better because this way you avoid importing stuff again and again by mistake. Russian bus plunges into the river. Yeah, we are ready. Past Savory, not much material on YouTube for that. So I will again try to run the imports with Shift F8. This time I'll be smarter. Oh, we have a lot of duplicates already. Well, let's clear them up. And not much left. As you can see, there could be some shorts, and shorts don't import as YouTube. You need to import them as link, unfortunately, but shorts you can watch, you know, YouTube itself. You don't need incremental video for that. I selected with YouTube, close on import. And import. So now you see I enter this kind of loop. I search for some supplementary materials, import, add to extending, review, just start, incremental video procedure. When I find something more I want to learn about, then again, YouTube, import, outstanding, review. And in this cycle, I can go ad infinitum, it's never boring. Each time I find something interesting, I add to my project file. So all it generates really lots of pleasure of watching. That's really a fun procedure. Now I would like to show you how I do extracts for presentations. So let's find something that could be extracted. Oh, here's some sweet video. An older man driving a steam car. Now that's fun to show for my presentation. So let's see. Stop it here. Extract. If I go to the next element, it will get extracted automatically, but I'll do it now. I extract armor with a yellow template to easily distinguish from other videos. Now we can use this extract as part of my project file. So I'll go to Control G, copy the element, that's for the sake of making the link. That's 835, element number 835, control copy. go to my best videos, and here, which year was it? 1908, I forgot. 1908 steam car. And I'll make a link by pasting the element number to this keyword. So shift insert. Shift insert. We'd like to paste the link, yes. Now let's check if it's really 1908. Yeah. And this way I'm expanding my best video links for the project file. So those links will be used in my project. I'm not sure which ones. I'm just picking out the best ones. A little bit of mess, and it's not chronological, it's just like how I find it, which are most interesting. So I have Jay Leno get steam blown in his face. And he's a great fan of steam cars. That's interesting. Probably Euro 4. Who can pronounce that? Combustion engine in Napoleon's time. No wonder it was forgotten with this kind of name. So now generally have a good idea of how it works. So we import new stuff, learn, reprioritize, put to different places in your learning schedule, extract best pieces for your project file, have lots of fun. But there's one thing which distinguishes YouTube learning in SuperMemo from incremental reading. In teamwork, we can work, watch together. If you find you know, sufficiently democratic rules, we can take four guys working together on a single project, watch together, have fun, discuss, extract together. I mean, one needs to operate the keyboard, the rest are just passive watchers and commenters, but it's possible. You can use Discord for that or any other application that makes it possible to work in teams. Let's have a look at a couple of videos.
We plot the pressure and volume inside the piston cylinder for one cycle, like this. The area inside is the work done, but this is the idealized PV diagram. In practice, there is a lot more energy being wasted. We lose a big chunk here because the steam is prevented from expanding. This can cause vibrations and jerky movement. We can reduce this with the use of a flywheel, which stores rotational energy with inertia and evens the torque out. It's essentially a mechanical battery.
Because steam is pushing on the piston in one direction and then the other, back and forth, while the opposite side is venting through the exhaust, it is called a double-acting cylinder. It is this intermittent venting of the steam that causes this familiar sound of a locomotive.
First thing we do is turn on the ignition, and I turn on my water pump by pulling up this plunger. You hear water pumping. Okay, see the pressure climbing? Okay, that's water. It's about 500. Put the pumps down. And I turn on the burner and watch the window down there.
Incredible. So with incremental video history, even if you don't like it, can be fascinating.
We don't want to pull away until I have temperature reading here. Pressure shuts off at 750. See, so I will crack it just a hair, let some water out. Pressure goes away. Pressure and temperature start to build up again together as a unit. Now, when you see that fire in the window, you see the fire going in a circular motion. That cream-colored paint you see on the inside, that's a plasma coating that just works phenomenal. This one here is pressure. You haven't seen the temperature needle yet. It'll come up in a minute. Okay, it's starting to come up now. Here it is. See here? We're at 250. Top it off with water. Now, if you want to go fast, we use Evian racing water.
Really?
No, not really. That's just being stupid. And we are ready to motor.
Motor. Yeah, incredible. So history can be fascinating. Just use the right tools. YouTube, what's better?